Hello everybody, my name is Theodore and I'm gonna show to you today a few things about linear spaces. More particularly in the linear spaces, we're gonna talk about Bayes' linear independent system and system of generators. Okay, so we are we know a few linear spaces from the basic school. For example, the space.
So let's try linear spaces.
Okay. A few examples of linear spaces are
we know.
X squared
with the addition operation.
Yeah.
So how do we define this?
Well,
X squared is
compounded by
the elements of the following form: a1, a2. It's a property that a1 is R.
Okay. Also,
we can generalize this as the square root of R, or so the this board.
Well, not exactly this board, but if we extend it unlimited on up and down.
This board is considered a linear space in this operation.
We can fix the origin
and choose another point A,
and we have
the linear space of the
called vectors, right?
So R squared can be set like the set of the vectors OA with the property that A lies in the plane, which we can set.
Okay. We are familiarized, I suppose, with the linear spaces, but I'm gonna present, especially today, the notions of linear independent system and system of generators, and combine these two notions.
Linear independent. So we have this, and this base, sorry.
Okay.
These are connected,
these notions. Okay. For example, let's take functions, continuous functions.
Defined on the bounded set AB, interval AB, continuous. F2, F3, continuous. We have it in the domain D, including the R.
Right?
It's pretty included because, is 0, right? That means it depends on the functions. F1 is different from F2, F2 from F3, and F3 from F1. Okay, so that results that if from here it results as alpha 1 f1 x plus alpha 2 times f2 x plus alpha 3 times f3 of x equals 0. Well, I know some functions which are which respect this condition. For example, f1 of x equal with let's say 2 f2 of x 1 not 1 3 and f5 of x minus 5 f3 of x. Okay, so there exists alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha 3 that the linear combination of this is 0. Why? For example, for alpha 1 equals 1, alpha 2 equals 1, and alpha 3 equals minus 1, this is 5, right? Okay? It resolves that f1 of x plus f2 of x minus f3 of x equals 0. Okay, so f1, f2, f3 are not linearly independent, right? But let's take the function of sine of x, sine of 2x, and sine of 3x. These three functions are linearly independent. Well, let's suppose that a1 sine of x plus a2 sine of 2x plus a3 sine of 3x equals 0. Okay, so we're gonna see if a1, a2, and a3 are zero. Let's get the definition of linear independent system. If v1, v2, vn are elements, vectors from the linear algebraic class V over K, where K is a field, right? Okay, we call that V1, V2, and Vn are independent if and only if and only if, not only if, but the reverse actions are obviously alpha 1 v1 plus alpha 2 v2 plus alpha n vn is 0 implies alpha 1 equals alpha 2 equals alpha n is 0, where alpha 1 alpha n are scalars from the field K, right?
Let's test if this function, if these three functions are linearly independent. Well, wait a second. Draw this. Plus A2
over 2 from 0 to p, and finally a3 dot minus cosine of 3x over 3 from 0 to p. This is 0, right? Okay, so we have a1 minus cosine of p plus cosine of 0 plus a2. This helps, but it's not enough, because we need to find at least one more relation between a1 and a3. So let's continue. Minus cosine of p is
the second iteration,
combined with this one, that's right here,
A1 plus A3 over 3 equals 0. If you do that, A2 is 0.
Okay.
And I guess that A1 and A3, to demonstrate that it's also 0, would be that far. Well, A1. So A1 sine x plus A3 sine 3x is 0 from the left, isn't it?
Yes?
Okay. So that means A1 sine of x plus A3 sine of 3x. It means that let me think. Sine of 3x is A1 sine of x plus A3 3 sine of x.
Where is it? Here. 3 sine of x
minus 4 sine of x. The third power of x. This is F0. And from here, A1 sine of x plus 3A3 sine of x minus 4A3 sine of the third power of x. This is 0. Okay?
Well, this is a constant function because it is a continuous function. So let us try to for x equals with p over 2. That means we have a1 plus 3a3 minus 4a3 equals 0. It means that a1 minus a3 is 0. So a1 is equal to a3, first of all. And a1 plus a3 over 3 is 0. So a1 plus a1 over 3, meaning a1 dot 4 over 3, this is 0. So it results that a1 is 0 and a2 is 0. Which means that sine of x, sine of 2x, and sine of 3x are linearly independent. This is a very interesting example because Fourier series, and we will know that every
continuous function can be approximated by a series of sine of x and sine of cosine of x and so on, sine of 2x, sine of nx, cosine of x, cosine of nx. That means that the space of the continuous functions over every interval you want, let's say 0 and 2p, or a to b, is a linear independent system. The space of the continuous functions over bounded intervals. Okay. Well, let's give for homework. Let's give for homework. I think it's better for homework because my video camera has a small capacity of filming, like 15 minutes. So I don't want to waste my time with the other garbage talking and. A2 for x1 plus a2 for x2 plus a3 plus
V2, if V2 doesn't exist, plus V3 x3 plus V4 x4 is 0. Okay. What's next? V2 x2 plus C3 x3 plus B4 x4 equals 0, and the last one C1 x1 plus C2 x2 plus C4 x4 equals 0. So we must prove that we're not true. The x1, x2, x3, and x4 are 0, right? Have been three. Okay, never mind. And C1, C2, 0, C4. Let's compute this determinant. So it should be A1 times 0, B3, B4. B2, B3, C4, and C2, 0, C4. Okay? Minus. B1, A2, A3, 0. So this must be 0, not 0, unequal to 0, okay? But this depends, this equality depends on the numbers chosen here. So we don't know for sure that these matrices are linearly independent. It depends who is A1, B1, C1, A2, B2, C2, and etc. etc. So, try to find at home some matrices of this type that are linearly independent, because this is very important to build a base. We'll soon know what it means to build the base of the linear space of this matrix. B. besides of a linearly independent system, to have a base, what's a base? So, a base. For linearly, for the linear space P plus P index A. And so it's a K linear space is a set P1, P2, Pn base. It is a set P1, P2, Pn with the following properties.
Okay, but next time. This time we are finished. Okay, we have finished this. Next time I will present you another properties of bases and system of generators. Thank you very much.